every club with intention to do harm. With a prosthetic arm and smelling like Boone's Farm. Hiding in the tables as soon as I hear alarms. Paranoid deep that it's still from his own mom. Canary corn, artist with a bomb. Strapped to my stomach screaming. A lust that loves to drink. Drunk driving a tank. Rolling over a bank. Cops see me in faint. It's drastic. I'm past my limit of coke. I think I'm up my high by slitting your throat. Put some baby carriage into the street. Till it's mixed meat. Your mid's been beat. The minute I step on the street. This is fight music.
You know why my hands are so numb?
No.
My grandmother sucked my dick and I didn't come.
Oh.
Smacked this whore for talking crap. So what if she's handicapped? What? Bitch said
we're in the motherfucking co-main event of the evening. Y'all ready for this 956? Make some noise! This shit is mad fucking important, so I need everybody to chill the fuck up in the back with all respect. You know what I'm saying? Alright, it's my break. Representing that Eagle Pass, illegal pass of my people smash. The Ivy Law giving up for Jay Sounds. And to my left. We've seen me spar with this man before. He's representing that motherfucking nighttime town for the footage. Y'all give it up for TheEmCee, ladies and gentlemen.
Adam B.
Adam B. All right, Since you came early, Jay Stylez, you opted for Eloquence to go first. What's the word y'all want? 90 seconds? Something like that?
A minute?
Really, that's what you said.
This is my
call.
All right. Let's get it in. Let's go, Eloquence. It's on you. Hold it down in the back. Hold it down in the back. It's not important.
Mad entertaining. You moody-eyed, goofy-eared, excessively depressing-looking individual.
Oh,
yeah. I bet staring in the mirror make your eyes drag, and I bet your ears sag because you never hear them spit anything lyrical. Now, before you try to conjure up on that flip, that I promise and that comment would be fucking pitiful. Let me say that today's the day that those ears perk up like a clipped pit bull. I'm about to spit fistfuls. He gonna develop some bitch issues. After I sink his chin, I'll make his whole body fly out of his shoes. You really think your dumb fuck stage antics are gonna move through and spook me? I've been in the cage with some dogs who really can do damage. You Looney Tunes droopy. Joey got his views up on his YouTube account. He had to jump on a worldwide league's name with prestige and fame to get the same amount of views that I get straight from the local underground. And I'm not hating on your game. If the Duke can kind of slay, I should probably take the bout. But I still hesitate with taking every battle stage offered that's around. I guess you could say I'm a creative perfectionist who's never satisfied without taking the perfect route. And on the way to perfection, I guess my penance for my stubborn selfishness while in the session is paying my attention to one stupid-ass battle rapper who thinks his battles actually count. That's why it's my personal responsibility as a dope MC to let you know nothing you do, including battle me, will do anything for what you're trying to accomplish. Because your penmanship is redundant, your stage presence is repugnant, and when you land your bars, your reaction is the only reaction in the crowd that manages to look astonished. They say fake it till you make it, but I say make sure the fake gets demolished. They say the real recognize real, well on the real, consider why your eyes look like they're blinded by shoe polish.
So, it's for y'all faggots that been looking for trouble. I'll be talking about my ears and you'll think I'm gonna come with a rebuttal. See, what I do is I go to your house and grab me your spells. I fuck her right there in the couch. Next thing you know, she pulls on my big ears every time I eat her out. Yo, you battling me. Yo, hold up. Yo, you battling me now, wise guy. You're so white that if someone were to turn off the lights in here tonight, your skin color will light up the whole room like a bright light. Yo,
all, and your battle career is over, set with, done with, brother. So just remember, when someone telling you you're a bright man, they ain't talking about your intelligence, they're talking about your skin color. Oh. Listen here, you fucking worm. You're so white that you look like talking sperm. Spanish speaking Charlie Sheen mixed with Butter Bean with a little touch of Mr. Bean. And you wire, and you wire the Sheamus that comes on at WWE. And you know who I would fucking fear, because I bet you if someone would to put a blonde wig in his fucking beard up in here, you look like Britney Spears. Well, three times let me say it again. If someone was to put a blonde wig in his fucking beard up in here, it looked like Britney Spears. Only three times as white and four times as weird. And you won't get past it at night. You look like Blind Fury, but without the bad eyesight. And you don't even look fucking right, because you got the body of Al Bundy and the face of a hermaphrodite. Will Ferrell. I'll cut you to pieces and put you inside of the wheelbarrow and put you in a bag. I'm about to show you motherfuckers how I get rid of 956 trash. Yeah. You're in a bad situation. I look as I'll beat your ass was an MS-13 gag initiation. Ooh. And it's round one and I'm done killing this sucker. Since I'm Mexican, I end round one with chinga tu madre and me la pedas.
For a worthless cunt. Oh. You see, every single one of my competitors has been credible in his endeavors to some degree as an MC, but you are seriously the worst ever. You get all gassed up and yell chinga tu madre at the end of your verses, but if you want to get facts up in a world that actually moves packs up, if you always act enough, your character's deemed worthless. Those fake fucking soy chingón y me vale que un montón se pongan al tirón poses. Porque te parto el trombón like a taco stand open after the party. You're hopeless. My bars, opiates. I carve copious opuses, choruses and poems that follow me like locusts followed Moses. I'm toasting and coasting. You ain't throwing turbulent motion. I'm blurting and boasting. Sherman, you're stolen. Dipping your stash in corpse Kool-Aid and getting that brass juice sprayed on the grains that you smoking. You sucking on a wet batch of swag with those raps, and I know it's bad, but for you, I really do condone it. So it can be spoken how Joey got ridiculed this moment. For speaking like someone that should have really been gloating off of nothing. And that's why you wind up a pigeon coop opponent. Follow the acronym and map that. PCP is what you're talking.
Oh. Oh. There you go. There you go. There you go. Yeah.
Battle Kings.
Dale?
Shit.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Time. All right, go for it. It's on you.
Get him.
Why you keep talking shit? You keep talking creep. Why don't you just go ahead and just suck his dick? Oh, yo, in this battle, I don't think you know who you fucking with. You start talking shit, I'll snap back and grab that fist. You get pistol whipped until you lose all consciousness. See what's the consequence when you start acting like a cocky bitch? Or I'll grab that shank and start stabbing you in the back like an unloyal best friend. And it's sad to see that this is the best MC y'all got for me. This battle, I'm gonna end this in a tragedy. When I grab this battle king, grab his crown and smash it on the floor like if I was dissing a member of Aladdin. And this is the shit I do because I don't even fucking lie. I'll grab a bat, hit you over the head, and crack your dome. That's what I call having an open mind. And I'll beat your face in till your face turns red. Your bitch ain't smart, but she's good at sucking that dick. Now that's what.
Damn!
Now your bitch ain't smart, but she's good at sucking that dick. Now that's what I call being good when using your head. I'm here to prove to y'all that I'm fucking crazy. I'm about to knock the living fuck out of Spanish looking like Slim Shady. Plus, I got a burner that turned eloquence into a ghost, just like Patrick Swayze. It's round two, and I'm done killing this sucker. Since I'm a real Mexican, I am round two with chinga tu madre and me la pelas, motherfucker. Piece of cake, piece of shit. Wasting my fucking time.
That's all you, eloquence. Let's get it.
Mi abuelita siempre decía, dime con quién andas y te diré pero quién eres? Por eso está confirmado hoy en día que tú te juntabas con puros ojetes. Ponme atención, mejor vete. Contra mí ni lo intentes. Atrévete te y saca ese pinche cuete. Te parto en cuartos como el número que sigue después de 1 menos 13. Te dejo reprobando semestre tras semestre. Yo estoy acostumbrado a armar el antro con un sonido claro que a la gente los entretiene. Tú eres un vago en el juego del varo y nadie te quiere. Tus camaradas Big Cree y Corn nada más te dan la mano porque sus vatos son buena gente. Pero si no fuera por la voluntad de ellos, otros raperos en San Anto no te hicieran caso, te consideran un pendejete. Know hereditarily to make my point, because my point is you gone, yo. I'm fucking Lonzo. We stopped at the intersection in the Monte Carlo, but this time my pop point. This was your training day, fool, but you ain't making it through, except you in luck, cuz I could never be a cop. I just like the story's plot, but it couldn't be true, because honestly my favorite thing to do every morning after dropping my kid off in school is fucking hotboxing the ride, bumping Cree's DJ Screw. I could obviously never find the appeal to being a boy in blue, but I'll end with this. Tonight, I hope you get drunk as shit, fall asleep in your own piss, wake up late, have to take off on your trip and don't notice it. Then I hope the weather gets as hot as the devil's grip and the AC goes out on your whip. Then you get all rosado to the point that it hurts to stay in the seat. That way you can call into your chambao and find out no one can cover your shift, so you can finally understand the aggravation of having to put in real work while having to deal with the aggravation of some infant shit.
Here's some shit about Corn Creed. I don't know why you talking in Spanish bars. Why you criticizing me, bitch? If it wasn't for Mike Mel, no one would know who the fuck you are. Since you a battle king, I guess I'm about to take that poker out. I already took out one king, so I don't give a fuck what that shit you be talking about. Plus, I'm an ace, Jax. You should watch out where it comes out of your mouth before you get punched in the mouth. Then I grab your queen and make her put my dick in her mouth. Then I call telling my niggas to run in your house to kill 4 of your kids, 5 of your brothers, 6 people that just walking about. Kill 7 of your fam just sitting right there on the couch, break any of your bones, and these niggas are all spinning up. That's what I call straight and a royal flush. But you understand the metaphors that are coming out of my mouth? Look up poker, understand what the fuck I'm talking about. What's going on around you, bitch? Fuckings, I'm in a generous mood, and I let you decide the gun I shoot you with. You take a pick. I can grab that 9 and shoot you in your click, grab that 5th to shoot nose, legs, and chin, or take out that 6 shooter to shoot you with that 6, but either way is the way to go. But you're about to get hit with this 956, like you're about to get shot with your own area code. Now I've been moving reckless, and when I say what I hit you with that 956, I ain't talking about McAllen, Texas.
Ooh!
Yeah. Alright, that was a promo battle. You two, you be the judge. McCann and Ryan's making some fucking noise! Yeah.